Hey guys, welcome back to Small World Snooker Championship 2009 and part 17 of our career mode. In today's episode, we take on Stuart Bingham in the semi-finals of the Masters for a place in the final against Ronnie O'Sullivan, who has come through against Joe Swale 4-3. So, let's get into it. This is my record against Stuart Bingham. 6 wins and no defeats. But again, we haven't made a century break against him, so it'll be interesting to see if we can pull it off today. Thank you for all the support on the series. As always, it is doing crazily well on the channel at the moment, and I cannot wait to keep going with it until Snooker 19 comes out. We will be starting World Snooker 11 sometime next week, or if we lose today, tomorrow. Fantastic semi-final match at the Masters. So here we go, getting welcomed into the arena for this best of seven encounter. We've been playing very well this week. Good victory against Mark Selby, followed up with a deciding frame victory against Sean Murphy in the quarterfinals. And now we're ready to take on Stuart Bingham.
Quiet for the players, please.
Ball run, Stuart Bingham.
And it's his break. I wonder what he can do.
Very attacking break off to start us off.
Any more relaxed, he'd be asleep, wouldn't he?
And, well, nothing to go at, so be thin off this red. I'm gonna get the white somewhere near where it is now to cover that red on the left-hand side, as we looked before, and that's a pretty good line.
Great safety.
And a very good length.
He's back in board.
Is there a gap?
Safe.
That's the question. No, obviously wasn't, so just a thin safety from Stuart there. And that's a very good safety.
Safety.
Once again.
His safety shots are usually pretty standard.
So it's a very similar shot here as the one that we played before. As you can see, again, very good line. And a very good length. Picked one out there, goodness me. What a safety shot that is. And, well, I'm not sure whether that red goes. Difficult to tell. Get rid of this red. And maybe swing it over with a little bit of left hand side, try and get it somewhere near the yellow, although that is far too hard. And
I'd be tempted
to make
the
first
the blue
mistake. Oh, it did just go in. Goodness me, I thought that was going to miss, but it did just drop somehow. And now Stuart Bingham has the first chance in this Masters semi-final. Well, he's played safe. He must have been on anything, goodness me.
He's going to have to pull something out of the bag to get a pot here.
Be very disappointed that he only made 4 points there. So, similar safety to the ones we were playing before. If that misses the brown, it's perfect, although that little flick hasn't half helped. That's pretty good. And again, Stuart plays exactly the same shot and puts us in a lot of trouble, because now we're going to struggle to find that line. I mean, there's this one here. We are going to have to play this a lot harder to sort of swing it round. There could be a red that goes over the corner pocket here.
Looks
Where's
cold.
The cue ball going? Oh, well, that's unlucky. That is unlucky.
It's a shot to nothing, and he'll give it a whirl.
He's playing this one on the side cushion. Oh, unlucky. Well,
it was a no-lose situation, but you've got to take your chances at this level.
I guess he figured we would have took some sort of pot on, so he had to go for it.
He's controlled the cue ball nicely there.
But the consequence is that we've now got a really, really good chance I've taken a 1-0 lead here.
Follow up from that good pot.
So
this is about as simple as a shot as you could hope for.
If we play this with a loader right hand side, we don't have to play the cannon. And there you go.
The green looks like a decent bet.
Actually, I'm going to take the yellow. It's a more difficult shot, definitely a missable one, but gets us better position down the table.
He's got a pretty nice angle to nudge the black here.
That red is definitely possible.
So we just want to come back a couple of inches, ping into the... Oh dear. Well, I wasn't playing that. We got with the plant on the red there. I'm guessing we got some sort of double kiss there. So we must have potted the red cleanly.
Oh yes.
But what a beautiful black that is.
There's a few reds available. Decisions.
Just gonna drop this red in. So the pink into the left middle.
It's fine if the cue ball doesn't misbehave.
Stun it up a little bit. Wow, we missed the pink. That is a really terrible shot.
Yep, he's got where he wanted to go. That's gone in.
Not expecting that. Just shows you take your eye off the pot for 1 minute, and that's what happens. So, Stu Bingham, over to you now.
You can go down here.
What sort of chance can he get himself here? He's got the back on his spot.
To play here.
Tough pot here, though.
A little luck.
Oh, right in the heart of the pocket. Brilliant shot.
That one didn't present too many problems.
And this is a great chance for the 2015 world champion here.
It's a decent pot that puts him in.
Obviously, this game was made a long time before he was even in the top 16.
I think you'll put some screw on it.
But still, a very solid player. Very good break builder. Very lucky there. So 25 points the lead. This goes to 32.
This could be a critical.
Plays the cannon, and yeah, you would imagine he'll take this frame now.
To make the frame safe.
So just this black and one more red.
The black goes.
So just this red required, and he takes it.
What he was after.
So Stu Bingham takes this opening frame, punishes us for that miss pink, which was out of character for us, really.
He's on a decent run of scoring here,
and certainly looks up for it today.
Expected a better positional shot there,
and no chance of a century, unfortunately, for Stuart, but still a massive confidence boost to.
I might think of disturbing the pink from the cushion. Can he?
He's expecting to pot this one.
To clear the table. Although he's missed the pink. So that break of 82 gives Stu Bingham the first frame, and he now leads 1-0. So, a little bit of a shock for us. A shock to the system, I guess, in that first frame.
I wonder if it will follow the same pattern as the first.
That was a poor break. Chance now, and he's put it in. So good shot there from Stewart.
Could very much buy the book, this player. Yeah, another black gets on the cards. We've got the black.
So once again, Stu Bingham in.
Inside the cluster will surely go.
It was a poor break from us. Now, is he on anything? Well, he's on this red to the right corner. Oh, that was a poor shot. He needed to play that with a bit more conviction. So he breaks down on 25 and plays an absolutely rubbish safety. Well, gotta take our chance after that. That's a massive unforced error.
That's the first points for him this frame.
He should be able to get the angle he wants from here.
Gotta take our chance. It's going to be tough to get on a red, but I'll try and get on that one near the middle. Very fortunate there.
The blue spot sitting pretty.
Looks like he's thinking of potting the brown.
Well, green it is. I'm going to play this with lots of right hand side and try and get into that pack. Wasn't the biggest target in the world.
Too much emphasis placed on the pot there.
He made the pot without too much difficulty, but he's left some work to be done with his next.
Just drop this right into the middle. And it's there.
Another
good shot.
Looks advisable here.
The blue's slightly in the way here, so we're going to have to play it with a load of left-hand side, swing it round the angles.
Not positionally.
Well, that's gone wrong again. So
can't see anything easy out there.
This does cut. This does cut. It's thin, but it does cut. There you go. And now we've actually got an angle on this brown, smack straight into the pack here. Play it quite soft, so that gives the brown every chance, but this could develop everything.
The brown well there.
On target, how's we look? Perfect.
Positional shot.
So you'd expect us to go on and win the frame now. If our form from the opening two matches is anything to go by.
He can be on the red quite nicely from here.
And the two tournaments that we've won already in the series.
It's a decent break that. He's got a useful angle to get on the blue.
Well, I'm not sure how he's going to find a way to play the ball here. He needs the cue ball to play ball, so to speak.
Need a good bounce off the cushion. Didn't quite work out there, but
can't get nicely onto the black again from here.
This red should give him the requisite angle for the black.
Should be able to get on the pink.
Lead him on the next red.
That's okay. So screw it back.
It's a decent break that.
Again, just slightly under hit, but
this is about as simple a shot as you could hope for.
So I'm just going to find the gap here. Oh, we see we hit the pink.
Rather tilt at this green.
This pink is now a lot more difficult than it should have been. We could go in off. We could go in off. Oh, wow.
Just needs to hold position for four more shots. Two reds and two colours.
I think we want to get nicely on the black after this one. He's only got his mind on one thing, potting this black.
Just got to drop this black in.
A red and a colour will do it for him.
Any colour, and we're back on level terms.
It's a good pot.
Played quite well here.
For the next.
The frame's safe. He's taking the pressure off himself now.
The position isn't ideal, but not too bad. Cool as a cucumber, is he?
I'm dropping in.
It's looking good with this visit.
So what are we on? 73, wow. We can make a century here.
He's played a good shot there.
Just. So we will actually concentrate. But it's been a good break.
Doesn't present too.
And it does probably deserve a century, you would imagine.
But once you run out of position, it can be a nightmare trying to regain
this
it.
This could be enough, though. Ooh, just enough.
He's controlled the cue ball nicely there.
Just got to drop this blue in. Overhit it slightly. So I'll have to play this pink into the middle.
He's dispensed with the pink knife.
There. So Justice Black for the Sentry. And be back on level terms. And there it is. Another Sentry for us in this career mode. And we level things up in this semi-final. 1-1 now. We punished Stuart for that. Very poor safety on the black. And he never got another shot. So I think we can be reasonably happy with that. Although we hit the bump there. And Stuart's going to have the first chance here.
Could have done a little better.
It wasn't his best shot, but he'll probably settle for it.
He's going away with that.
That could set things up nicely. It's a decent pot that puts him in a good position.
So again, Stuart in first.
He likes to keep a very sure and steady pace to his game. Nicely done. It wasn't easy to get the pot and the position.
Not in an ideal position, but he's still in with a chance.
Tough blue.
Goodness me. If he'd made the pot, he might have had a chance to go on from there.
That was a tough chance, but a chance nonetheless.
He needs to
breathe. Developing team.
This is a decent chance from the blue to go into the pack like we did with the brown.
It's a good pot and things might just start to open up in front of him here.
Just a little bit off target there.
For breaking into that cluster.
It's a tough red. Goodness me, that's a tough red. In real life, this would be tougher, but on the game, a much more comfortable shot than that cutback. Great, and that's stuff. Right in the heart of the pocket. Just need to hit this, not with a lot of pace.
That was
just
a nice
make
move.
Sure we get some sort of contact, and there you go.
Yep, he's got where he wanted to go.
There's a chance to follow up from that good pot.
Come back a couple of inches for that pink into the right middle. And all of a sudden, this is a really, really good chance.
He made light work of that. It's important he gets a good angle on the black.
If he can pot this red and get nicely on the black, there's no reason why the following red shouldn't be a cinch.
Just had a nick a bit of the pocket there, but we're okay. I don't know where the black's going to go.
Well, he'll be pleased that at the very least he's got a bit of potting practice there. He's got options here.
Didn't go where I thought it would. I thought it would still be pottable into that. Right corner, but it isn't, so pink it'll have to
he
be.
He needs the cue ball to play ball, so to speak.
He needs John Virgo to shut up on his shots, so to speak. Nice
it's
shot
a good
there.
Pot, and he's well poised for the next.
He's looking at the red next to the pink.
I'll screw this back.
Great.
A bit much, but we're on the blue.
Good pot on the blue.
There's a chance to follow up.
I don't think that black goes, so
he's going to need the spider for this one, then.
Need that to pull up, and it's not going to.
He's not placed enough emphasis on positioning there. Good pot, mind.
So, tough brown. Oh, right in the heart of the pocket.
Get the pot and the position will please him.
So, I'm just going to screw it back a little bit. Oh, he's okay.
He's okay.
Just drop this pink in.
This could be a critical break. He's notching the points up nicely.
That could be end of break.
He's going to have to pull something out of the bag to get a pot here.
He'd be mad not to play safe, in my opinion.
Well, it was coming. Yeah, we hadn't played a good shot for quite some time, really. So, play this with a lot of right-hand side to try and swing it round. And the green, oh, that red's going to come up with us. Got away with it.
Safe.
Bit of an interesting shot. I thought
he's not by his opponent at all.
I thought he might go for something there.
Oh!
Oh, that red's gone over the corner, and that's unlucky.
That's a fantastic shot from range.
Surely that black doesn't go. It doesn't.
Second-rate shot.
The blue.
Well, if you don't get the pot, you can't continue your break.
Just about.
Slight pressure on this next
so
shot.
So that's pink.
Should be okay if he keeps his cool.
And we take a 2-1 lead.
That one puts the
frame. Like it.
He's taking the pressure off himself now.
Well, I didn't know this red went. Well.
His opponent needs snookers now. Won't get position.
So he's 39 points in behind with 35 on the table. So one snooker. And that was a poor shot. And there we go.
Super position.
Don't think he'll play out here, so we miss the brown.
He's giving it up.
Yes, he does concede. So with that earlier break of 52, we take this third frame, and we now lead 2-1 for the first time in the match. Very happy with that, and I think Stuart will be slightly disappointed that he's been in first twice in the last two frames and lost both of them, but can he make a third time lucky here?
Surely, he's looking in good shape here. He'll try his damnedest to get nicely on the black.
And he's got a good chance of being in position for another black.
Won't be long before he'll be trying to bring a few reds out into the open.
Well, he's going direct into the pack. That was always going to be tough. I'll still go red. Gets it. Good pot. Missed there, but it forced its way in.
It's a decent break, that.
Oh.
He won't be too disappointed to be going for black again.
Well. Again. Good chance here. He's 41 ahead. Oh, he's missed the black. Oh, is it in the other one? No, it's not. Well,
his opponent should have made that a little more difficult, I think.
49 points the lead. Still plenty on the table for us. You have to say, this is a great chance to get into the cluster and open everything into play.
Great blocking.
Oof.
Any more relaxed, he'd be asleep, wouldn't he?
Very disappointing that we didn't make a fuller contact, but we'll go for the shot to nothing and we get it.
He does like to play the odd adventurous shot, just to keep his opponent on his toes.
And I think we have to go for this.
Brilliant!
And it's there.
Amazing shot.
13.
Sorry about that brief cut, but a really good chance here to come back at Stewart.
That puts him in a good position.
Bit wayward
well,
there.
It's worked out okay. Didn't quite play it like that, but I'm still settled for it.
Yeah, another black looks on the cards.
Well, he'll be pleased that at the very...
If he just plays this without being over elaborate, he'll be on the black, I'm sure.
I reckon he's got a good chance of being in position for another black.
The position looks good for him here.
Just need to make sure
consideration here.
That this red will still be available. I think it should be, as long as the pink spots. Which it does.
We'll almost certainly try to cultivate a nice position on the black here.
The one near the pink's worth a look.
We've played this break quite well. A little bit left hand side, swing it over. A little bit too much there.
Not in an ideal position, but he's still in with a chance.
Should be able to put this one away, just needs to concentrate. To get the pot and the position will please him.
So I've just got to run this on and off the cushion. On the yellow. So we're 2 points ahead, so we need yellow, green, brown and the blue to lead 3-1.
Takes the green with a certain ease.
Not ideal.
Can't see anything easy out there. Looks like he's gonna need to use the rest for this shot.
And that's there.
This blue will win it for him.
He can take the frame with this shot. That'll be a weight off his shoulders. He's rather clean with himself, isn't he?
And this has again been a good break.
This could be a critical break. He's notching the points up nicely. And he needs the practice, I think.
Stewart will be devastated, but with that break of 78, we take the fourth frame and now lead 3-1. Needing only one out of the next three frames
to be behind in
to seal our place in the Masters final. And I think we've played particularly well.
Always helps psychologically.
You know, I think Stewart has been playing nicely and, oh, well, a little bit of luck there for us. Goodness me, I mean, we'd got the pace of the safety absolutely inch perfect, but we are going to go for this.
And?
What are we on?
I'd go for a position on the pink.
He has a very no-nonsense approach to how he plays snooker.
I mean, I guess we can play a little stun shot. Play the pink into the middle.
Nice pop, but what about the positioning?
Well, I think we can. Yeah. John Parrott spooked us there. But, oh, great, that goes on
pop,
the green spot, so...
Well.
Interesting.
There's a few roads he can go down here.
Perfectly, so.
Great position.
He might well get a lovely shot at the black from here.
It's important he gets a good angle on the black. On target.
He should be able to get the angle he wants from here.
I'm just going to come on and off the cushion here.
He's looking good with this visit. Nothing spectacular. But he's building a nice break.
Where's that 26. Black going to go? Ooh, just about spots.
I reckon he's got a good chance of being in position for another black.
Which of the available reds will leave him in best stead to continue the break?
Play this one.
The black's looking like a good bet again.
So just a little stunt. We're okay. stood up for this black. And this is a really good chance now. Already 42 points in front. Still plenty of reds on the table. And it all came from that fluke.
Amazing putt. That's a decent shot.
So, if this cannon goes correctly, this should be the match winner. Oh, well, it couldn't have went much better, to be honest with you. Absolutely inch perfect on this red. Nicely on the black, and honestly, this has been a really good performance from us.
He's picking up points like a vacuum cleaner here.
Already 66 in front, this red and the black. And we are in the final. Well, we've overhit that somewhat.
So the position is not ideal, but not too bad.
Stun over for that red into the yellow pocket.
That'll be a way to
control. That's
there. Oh,
I mean, it's a flattering scoreline. I feel like Stewart has played his part most definitely in this match, and you know, after taking the opening frame very well, and you know, making a 49 before breaking down that last frame, he's certainly going to be kicking himself, you would imagine, at not having won a couple of more frames and maybe even won this match. But he's come up against us in form, and you know, we've already made one century. Oh, we went enough. Never mind, that's end of break there. But with that break of 81, it's enough to take a 4-1 victory and go into the final against Ronnie O'Sullivan, the rematch of the Shanghai Masters final. There you have it then. Highest break of 100, he made it 82 in the first frame. But we played very, very well. We potted pretty much everything we went for. Did miss a couple, but overall a very, very strong performance, and we can go into the final with a lot of confidence. If you've enjoyed that, then make sure you leave a like down below. Really does help me out, means a lot to me as well. Subscribe to the channel for regular snooker content, and I'll see you guys for the next episode, where we'll be taking on Ronnie O'Sullivan in a best of 19 final for the Masters. Don't miss it. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.